This is the first Microsoft Surface Duo. It's a phone from 2020, but how does it hold up in 2022? Let's find out. Let's start with price. You can still find them brand new and they are around 400 to 500 euros, which is a lot cheaper than the starting price, because when the phone was released, it was about 1500 euros. The phone has a Snapdragon 855, 6GB of RAM, 256 or 128GB of storage, a single 11MP camera, and flash. The phone is made out of glass from the front and the back. It looks really nice and it feels good in the hand, but because of it, it is more fragile, and I actually broke the back of my phone and now it is cracked. So I prefer plastic over glass, but on the other hand, plastic feels cheap, and if you spend a lot of money on your device, you don't want it to feel like a crappy device. The hinge also feels really good, and you can easily fold it up to protect the screen and use it like a tablet or use it like a smartphone as a normal display. And I actually use this as my main phone right now. It is a bit wide, but I also really like it because everything is a little bit bigger, and if you want a bigger screen, you can also get this. You can also hold it like this and then use this as a keyboard on the bottom, or scroll through apps, which is really nice because you have almost like a tablet in your pocket. For ports, it only has a single USB-C port, no headphone jack. I always find it disappointing when a phone doesn't have a headphone jack, but on this one I understand it because it's really thin and it has two screens. It's still disappointing, but Bluetooth works fine. On the side, you will find three buttons: volume up, volume down, a power key, and also a fingerprint sensor underneath it. The fingerprint sensor is separate from the power key. Unlike the Sony Xperia 1, this fingerprint sensor actually works pretty fast and reliable. I haven't had a lot of issues with it. The buttons feel pretty good, even with the Surface case on it. And it is a little bit disappointing that there aren't a lot of cases for this phone, because it's really unique. But the bumper that is included is fine. It doesn't protect it a lot because it's damaged, as you can see, but that is one trade-off of a foldable. Also, because the phone folds inwards, you can't really have a screen protector on the phone, because if you add a screen protector, you will probably get issues with closing it. The battery life on this phone is surprisingly good. It has a 3577 mAh battery, and that doesn't sound like a lot, especially when you have two displays, but I can actually get through a day, even when I use both screens. It isn't amazing and you won't get 2 day or 3 day battery life, but it's definitely, in my opinion, much better than some other phones that I have tested. So you can probably get through a day, but if you use it a lot, then you might need to carry a power bank with you. And I am really surprised because this device is so thin and they were still able to manage to get a good battery life in this device. The screen of the phone is really interesting because it has a 3:2 aspect ratio, and that means it is really wide, which means that apps will look a lot bigger compared to some other phones. So text will be a little bit bigger, and it definitely feels a bit different. Also in the hand, it is a lot wider, which means that when you hold it, it feels a little bit weirder, but I definitely got used to it. The screen is really good and it can get bright enough for outside. So the brightness is bright enough and the screen looks good. The speaker on the phone isn't that good. It is usable and it's fine for calling or just quickly listening to something, but it's definitely not good. There are better speakers in phones, but it can get pretty loud. The fingerprint sensor is on the side and it can unlock pretty quickly, and I haven't had any issues with it, and I really like how it works. You just press it and it unlocks. Now about one of the weak points of this phone. It is the camera. The photo quality is fine. It isn't anything special, but it's also not horrible. When you get in lower light situations, it will definitely get a lot worse. You shouldn't buy this phone for the camera, because there are a lot of other phones out there with much better cameras. When you hit the shutter button, it always takes a while for it to take a photo, and it's just so annoying. And it just makes it a very annoying camera to use, because if I hit the shutter button, I want it to take a photo, but it takes a while for it to take a photo. Another thing about this phone that isn't so good is the software. I definitely noticed that the update support is nice, and I actually get a lot of updates on the phone. So they are definitely trying to improve it and keep it on the latest version with the security updates. I would rather have a phone that has a little bit less updates and is more stable, like the Xperia, than a phone that gets constantly updated but doesn't feel smooth and sometimes glitches out. For example, sometimes I only have one screen open, but it thinks I have both screens open, so it will also have the screen on the back open. And then I sometimes randomly open an app on the other screen while I am using it like this. And it's so annoying. And sometimes also the flash randomly turns on, so then I get it out of my pocket and then I look at the screen and then the flash gets really bright in my face. It's annoying. So the stability isn't good. And also it has some issues with launchers because of the dual screen. I think the design of the software is nice and it is actually pretty fast. It isn't really slow and it works nice. And it would have been nice if it was a little bit more stable. So, should you buy one in 2022? If you want a foldable phone like this and you don't mind the glitches and the bad camera, then you might want to consider it. But keep in mind that the phone is sometimes a little bit unstable with the software, and also the screen is really wide, which is a little bit different compared to other phones, and the camera is also just bad. But you do get a really big display, and there aren't a lot of phones that offer a large display in a compact size at this price point. Thank you for watching.